Most people fight aging with supplements or protocols like plasmapheresis or stem cell therapy. But what if one of the most powerful tools isn't something you take, but something that's already inside of you? Your natural killer cells are part of your immune system's frontline defense, targeting aging and damaged cells before they cause trouble. The problem? They weaken over time. But a new therapy could flip the switch and bring them back to life. And the implications for aging are huge. Your immune system isn't just about fighting off colds. It's one of the key systems that controls how you age. And one cell type plays a bigger role than most people realize: natural killer cells, or NK cells. They quietly patrol your body, clearing out damaged, dysfunctional, and even precancerous cells. But as you age, their power fades, and that's when the problems begin. In this video, we'll break down what NK cells actually do, how they influence the aging process, and what cutting-edge science is doing to bring them back online. By the way, I'm Hitch. I spent the last 7 or 8 years deep in the science of aging, experimenting, optimizing, and tracking every variable I can. This isn't just a passion, it's a disciplined pursuit. This is what I do all day, every day. Natural killer cells, or NK cells, are a specialized type of white blood cell that plays a crucial role in the immune system. Unlike other immune cells that need a heads up before launching an attack, NK cells are your body's rapid response team. They patrol the body, hunting for cells that are stressed, infected, or damaged, and eliminate them before they cause harm. Think of them as your immune system's frontline assassins. This makes them a key defense, not just against cancer and viruses, but against aging itself. But here's the kicker. As we get older, the immune response starts to slow down. It's called immunosenescence, and it's one of the hidden drivers of aging. NK cells lose their edge, which means that harmful cells, including the senescent ones, start slipping through the cracks. Senescent cells are old, damaged cells that should have died already. Instead, they linger around like bad guests at a party, spewing inflammatory signals that accelerate aging and disease. When NK cells can't keep up, these senescent troublemakers multiply, leading to chronic inflammation, tissue breakdown, and a higher risk of diseases like cancer and heart disease. If NK cells are this important, then the obvious question is, can we bring them back online? Can we rearm these assassins? That's where adoptive NK cell therapy enters the picture, with the potential to reboot your immune system and give aging cells the boot. Adoptive NK cell therapy is a next-gen approach designed to do one thing: restore and enhance the function of NK cells. Now, here's how it works. Scientists extract NK cells from your body, multiply them in the lab, and then reinfuse them to boost immune surveillance. The goal? To reawaken your body's built-in defense force and clear out cancerous and senescent cells, reducing inflammation and slowing the aging process. In other words, it's like upgrading your immune system from dial-up to fiber optic. Now, compared to some other anti-aging tools, this one's got some serious advantages. Senolytic drugs aim to kill off senescent cells, but they're like sledgehammers. They're blunt, you have to keep taking them, and they can have off-target effects. NK cell therapy, on the other hand, could deliver long-term benefits with just one well-targeted infusion. And unlike CAR-T cancer therapies, which require complex genetic engineering, NK cells already know how to find trouble. They naturally migrate to the hot spots, tumors, inflamed tissue, or cellular chaos, making them a more flexible and efficient tool in longevity therapeutics. Emerging research is backing this up. Adoptive NK cell therapy could help counteract immunosenescence, rejuvenating the immune system and reducing the pro-inflammatory environment that drives aging. We're talking about dialing back the inflammatory noise and giving your immune system a second wind. Recent studies in adoptive NK cell therapy have shown promise in rejuvenating immunosenescence, eliminating senescent cells, and alleviating SASPs. This progress provides a proof of concept for NK cell therapy in cell therapy and holds promise as an emerging revolution in longevity therapeutics. The evidence so far suggests that NK cell therapy could be one of the biggest breakthroughs in longevity science. But to fully understand its potential, we need to look at how NK cells actually work inside the body to maintain health and prevent disease. NK cells act as frontline defenders, constantly patrolling the body for abnormal or damaged cells. Now, unlike other immune cells, they don't rely on prior exposure to a pathogen or to cancer cells to recognize threats. Instead, they use a finely tuned balance of activating and inhibitory receptors to decide which cells get to live and which ones get nuked. When they detect a cell waving the molecular red flag, such as a virus-infected or senescent cell, they unleash a rapid attack. Their weapon of choice, the perforin granzyme pathway. NK cells release perforin, a protein that punctures holes in the target cell's membrane, creating entry points for an enzyme called granzyme. Once inside, these enzymes trigger apoptosis, a controlled form of cell death that prevents inflammation and tissue damage. This process is essential for clearing out dysfunctional cells before they can accumulate and contribute to age-related diseases. But NK cells don't stop at killing damaged or infected cells. They also lead the charge by signaling other parts of your immune system into action through cytokine signaling. They produce interferon gamma and tumor necrosis factor alpha, which enhance the activity of other immune cells, helping to orchestrate a systemic defense against disease. These cytokines also play a critical role in modulating inflammation, keeping it in check while ensuring effective immune surveillance. Problem is, as you age, their cytokine output drops. And that's one reason chronic low-grade inflammation, also known as inflammaging, starts creeping in. Another one of their killer moves, antibody-dependent cellular cytotoxicity, or ADCC. When antibodies bind to abnormal cells, NK cells recognize these tagged cells through their CD16 receptors, lock on, and launch an attack. This mechanism is particularly important for targeting senescent or cancerous cells that might otherwise evade immune detection. NK cells are first-line defenders in cancer by natural cytotoxicity and by mediating ADCC, making them crucial components for cancer immunosurveillance. When it comes to aging, one of the most critical roles NK cells play is the elimination of senescent cells. Senescent cells are basically the walking dead, cells that have stopped dividing but won't die. Instead, they linger in tissues and secrete pro-inflammatory molecules known as senescence-associated secretory phenotypes, also known as SASPs. NK cells are one of the only lines of defense against this buildup. Over time, the buildup of these cells accelerates tissue dysfunction, fueling diseases such as cardiovascular disease, neurodegenerative disorders, and cancer. Studies show that NK cell infusions can reduce markers of senescence and lower inflammation levels for up to a year. Studies in vitro and in animal models have shown that NK cells actively eliminate senescent cells. The orchestrated clearance of senescent cells by NK cells is pivotal for upholding tissue homeostasis. But there's a catch. NK cells don't always win. Cancer cells can play dirty, hiding their distress signals or actively suppressing NK cell activity. Some cancers even reprogram NK cells, turning them into tumor-promoting agents rather than tumor killers. That's why researchers are now exploring engineered NK cells, like CAR-NK, designed to break through these defenses and restore the full kill potential. Still, even with these changes, the big picture is clear. NK cells are one of the most powerful tools we have for immune regulation, inflammation control, and cellular cleanup. Enhancing their function through adoptive NK cell therapy could provide a powerful means of reducing inflammation, preventing disease, and ultimately turning back the biological clock. Enhancing NK cell function delivers clear wins when it comes to aging and longevity. One of the biggest, slashing systemic inflammation. When NK cells clear out senescent cells, they shut down the release of SASPs, the inflammatory molecules that accelerate tissue deterioration and age-related diseases. That inflammation, chronic, low-grade, and persistent, is what drives a whole list of age-related conditions, from cardiovascular disease to neurodegeneration. By restoring NK cell activity, the immune system becomes much more efficient at suppressing this inflammatory cascade. Just as important, better immune surveillance. As we age, our ability to detect and eliminate abnormal cells becomes less effective. That's why cancer risk skyrockets. But research shows that individuals who maintain strong NK cell activity are more resilient to these diseases and may even experience extended health span. Healthy, elderly individuals who preserved NK cell function show greater resistance to age-related diseases, while those with diminished NK activity face higher risks of disorders like arteriosclerosis and increased mortality. By preventing the accumulation of dysfunctional cells and maintaining immune vigilance, NK cell therapy may help extend health span, potentially delaying the onset of age-related diseases and preserving overall vitality. Now, as we age, NK cell function declines and our bodies start losing the ability to clean house. Damaged and dysfunctional cells pile up, leading to an accumulation of cellular debris that disrupts cellular tissue function and accelerates biological aging. The inability to remove these dysfunctional cells contributes to frailty, metabolic dysfunction, and increased susceptibility to diseases like cancer, Alzheimer's, and cardiovascular disease. NK cells are one of the few tools that we have to fight that internal decay, but their power fades over time. That's where adoptive NK cell therapy could flip the script. Restoring NK cell function through therapy could help counteract this decline by rejuvenating immune surveillance and promoting a healthier internal environment. Human and animal studies show NK cell infusions improve metabolic function, immune health, and overall resilience. And here's the wild part. Some evidence suggests that enhancing NK activity earlier in life could delay the whole aging curve. It's not just a fix, it might be preventative. In younger subjects, enhanced NK activity has been linked to a delayed onset of age-related decline, suggesting that proactive interventions could help maintain immune function before significant deterioration occurs. Adoptive NK cell therapy isn't ready for the mainstream just yet, but it's getting close. Right now, it's still in the early stages of clinical development, with researchers fine-tuning how to harvest, expand, and reinfuse NK cells for the best results. Early data looks promising. It's been shown to be safe and effective in small-scale studies targeting cancer, immune dysfunction, and age-related decline. But access is still limited to research settings and high-end experimental clinics. The good news? Progress is fast. As protocols stabilize and safety data builds, broader availability is likely on the horizon, potentially making this one of the first cell-based therapies to move from the lab to longevity clinics. NK cells are your body's natural assassins, targeting cancerous, infected, and senescent cells before they can cause damage. But as we age, their power fades. That decline fuels inflammation, weakens immune defenses, and accelerates biological aging. Adoptive NK cell therapy could be a game changer. By restoring these cells to youthful levels, we may be able to slow or even reverse key aspects of aging. While clinical access is still limited, and early research shows it's safe, promising, and potentially long-lasting. In the meantime, don't wait on the science. You can support your NK cell function right now through smart lifestyle moves, high-intensity exercise, proper sleep, stress management, and targeted nutrition. Fasting, vitamin D, and compounds like quercetin and curcumin have all been shown to boost NK cell activity. The bottom line, NK cells are a critical piece of the longevity puzzle, and this emerging therapy could help unlock their full potential. Now, if you're interested in topics like adoptive NK cell therapy, you'll probably enjoy my free longevity community over on school.com. We do weekly live Q&A sessions on Zoom. There's a couple of free longevity courses. And like I said, it's free. Okay, that's it for me. I'm out of here. Catch you next week.